جس دن علی ابن حسین سیز وی سین اینجلز کمین اللہ اکبر دی روایت اف ترمذی سیدنا جبریل کیم اینڈ ملک الموت کیم ٹوگیدر جبریل نوکڈ آن دی ڈور ہی سیڈ یا رسول اللہ ھذا ملک الموت یستاذن او نبی اف اللہ دی اینجل اف ڈیتھ از آسکنگ پرمیشن ٹو کم انسائیڈ مستاذن علی آدمی قبلک ولا علی آدمی بعدک ہی نیور آسک پرمیشن فرسٹ مین از آسکنگ پرمیشن ڈو یو الاؤ ہم ٹو کم نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم سے جبریل ٹیل ہم ٹو کم انسائیڈ ہی کمز انسائیڈ ہی سٹس ڈاؤن Then Jibreel, the angel of death, says, Ya Rasulallah, Inna Allah arsalani ilayk. Allah has sent me to you to take your soul. If you permit, very politely, I will take it out. If you decline, I respect your request, O Nabi of Allah. Nabi Sassan says, I lifted my gaze. I looked at Jibreel. Jibreel said, Inna, Ya Muhammad, Inna Rabbaka ishtaqa ila liqa'ik. Your Allah is passionate to see you. Your Allah is waiting to meet you. Nabi Sassan says, then I just looked at Jibreel, the Malakul Maut. And I said, go ahead and do what you have to do. Malakul Maut comes and the soul of the greatest human that history has ever seen is taken out. Brothers, when the soul comes out, can we imagine what it must have caused among Sahaba, the confusion? Abu Bakr comes running. Umar radiallahu anhu becomes hysterical. He kisses Nabi alayhi salam. He says, Tibta hayyan wa mayyita. My Nabi, you are unique when you are living and you are equally unique now that you have gone. Arrangements for the ghusl is made. Those that are given ghusl, they start debating, should we remove the clothes or not? Alqallahu alayhimun naum. Allah puts a sleep over them. They go into a trance. And in that they hear a voice calling out to them, don't remove his clothes, give ghusl to him as he is. Ghusl is given to the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They come to Abu Bakr, do we perform janaza? He said, yes, janaza will be performed, but individually, who can become the imam of imams? The body was placed there, the men came and read and they went, the woman came and went. Abdullah ibn Zayd ibn Abd Rabbi comes. He said, oh Allah, these eyes were good when your Nabi was here. He's gone. What am I going to do with these eyes? Give me the honor that my last sight was your Nabi and make me blind on the spot. Allah make me blind, I call upon the Ummah. We are not asking Allah to make us blind. Allah make us thus that these eyes don't ever see haram. Allah let it when we return, it creates some consciousness in us. And then the time comes, Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah was in charge of digging the graves in Makkah. And Abu Talha, Zayd ibn Sahal was in charge of digging the graves in Medina. The body was brought, the grave was dug, and this body in this greatest amanat was lowered into the grave. What did Safiya radiallahu anha say? And I leave you with this couplet. She said, لا عمري ما أبكي النبي لموته ولكن لحرج بعدك آتيا. Oh Allah, we are not crying over the death of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but we are crying about two things. One is the bond between man and Allah through revelation was continued at the death of any prophet, but has permanently terminated at the death of Nabi alayhi salam. We are crying at the challenge that is to stay at us. And then she said, فَلَوْ أَنَّ رَبَّ الْعَرْشِ أَبَقَاكَ بَيْنَنَا سَعِدْنَا وَلَكِنْ أَمْرُهُ كَانَ مَاضِيًا. Allah, if you only spared him amongst us a bit longer, it would have been our fortune. But then again, we knew the reality had to prevail. Brothers, that is how the Nabi of Allah went. My question is, how am I going to go? How are you going to go? My Nabi said, every man will die in the manner he lived his life. The day you die in your normal life, there will be no difference. If your life is to get up daily after Fajr and you miss your Fajr, I'm afraid the day you die, you will also miss your Fajr. If your daily routine is to get up, go in the bathroom and shave, I'm afraid, my brother, you will shave the day you're going to go in your grave to meet your Nabi. I'm afraid that is the reality that will stare at you. I swear by Allah, there will be no change in your routine. If your routine is to start with Quran, you will start with Quran. If your routine is to start by bowing before Allah, you will bow before Allah. Every man is concerned, what will happen to my children the day I die? Is it not high time we start thinking, what will happen to my children the day they die? Allah give us the reality.